Okay, well, I don't know how much of this is what I'm about to tell you is true, so I'd like the people out there who do a little bit more research to do some. Now, I was at work at the restaurant the other day, and the owner, Fernando, was telling me, you know, it's fucked up that, you know, he had to hear a story on the radio. On the radio or TV, he comes into work, he says, have you heard the shit about the Border Patrol? I'm like, what? We're going down. And he told me that there was a Border Patrol agent, you know, working with the coyotes, or whatever they call those people who smuggle the smugglers. And he says this Border Patrol agent, over the last 5 years, made $30-some-odd million. How the fuck can you make $30-something million? And he says, the coyote gets $4,000 per unit to hustle a murderer. And the coyote was given the Border Patrol to do $1,500 a person. And what he would do is tell him the days he was working and, you know, just turn his fucking cameras off or turn off the sensors in that area. And they just drive on through. He get his money. Then he told me that they also found out that there were other Border Patrol agents letting cocaine and weed and all that shit get through. So I'm like, you know, how do you know about this shit? He said, it was on the news and shit. And he says, it's fucked up. You know, it's like, you know, and this is an older Mexican guy, and this man is pissed off that, you know, shit goes down like that. You know, about 8 to 10 years ago, there was that big tunnel through Texas, probably about almost 15, 20 years. So, I knew people who knew people. Well, I know this one guy who's actually worked on the tunnel. And he told me the only reason that they got busted is because the guy's wife was pissed off at her husband and told that they had the tunnel going underneath their property to Mexico. Got mad at the husband and told it because I think she didn't get no money or something she was asking for, and he told her no. So she went and told that they had the tunnel from Texas to Mexico. Shut them down. So, to hear that the Border Patrol is taking money to allow illegal immigration to just flow straight through is fucked up. To hear that the Border Patrol is allowing cocaine and marijuana to come through, that pisses me off. I wish I could have a job like that. Border Patrol, or some shit like that. Not just to send motherfuckers back or to fuck with people. It's that, come on, man. You're the first line of defense that you're letting shit go through. Defense. It's fucking stupid. You know, you ever had that problem with a big-ass fucking fence? Don't get me wrong. The fence could be, say, 60, 70 foot tall fence. Nah, fuck with you. But you could be in the rail about, say about 20 feet high. And I've been around 20 feet high and about, say, 8 feet thick. And at the top of this wall, like a rail track. Yeah, like rails. Just like, almost like a train track rails. And those rails would be lit up. I mean, like, what's the highest voltage you can put on something? I'd go and put that across the whole fucking rail. You can't climb under. Because, you know, the motherfucker's 10 feet down in the ground and 20 feet above the ground with an electric rail across that tap. And I have my, guards on the tram riding back and forth that rail. So that's what I would do. But it's pretty fucked up that the people that were paying take care of our borders, some of them are just letting people through. Now for this motherfucker to be greedy, I ain't gonna say greedy. $30 million. Now, take into consideration this. Once you do that, the people who consider yourself powerful, because if they can give you $1,500 per person to turn it back and you made $30 million at $1,500 a pop, that's fucked up. And about the cocaine this person had allegedly through 400 and something tons? Border Patrol. Check into it, I don't know if it's 100% true. And, did you see that ass kicking the police was fucking handed out? There was a lot of news. Apparently these guys get pulled over and cops were snatching them out the car and beating them. It's not like somebody's handcuffed and they're trying to get through the run. These people are getting snatched out of the car, literally, and handed ass weapons. The one cop was so much in a fucking frenzy, he's stomping on this one dude, then he runs to another pile of cops beating somebody, stomps on that guy, he can't get his feet in, so he runs back to the guy who was stomping and stomps on him some more. Apparently, they've had someone try to kill a cop on their force, and everyone they pull over now is going to receive these ass whippings. We as a society have lost our goddamn minds, and shit has gotten out of hand. I can't understand the Border Patrol, the police, and there's a city not too far from where I am right now called Vallejo, California. The city's resources are drawn bankrupt. I mean, the firefighters, the police are bankrupting this city. I mean, whenever a city goes down, you know, the people in the fucking city are paying their taxes. But the city is about to go bankrupt. I mean, what the fuck has happened to our political system, our politicians, our police officers, our Border Patrol? I mean, we all need so bad that we turn our backs and we turn our heads and we just let shit happen. We're so selfish in what we want or what we need. We just let shit happen. I've done a lot of videos the last 2 days. There were like 6 or 7 videos. I try to work the whole 10 minutes into my rep. So today, I like to tell people I'm going to take a short break from this thing. I'm going to focus on my music. So you'll be able to catch me over on Broke Man Studios. You know, I got that too. I got a man called Mr. Davis coming in today. And we're going to do his first couple of songs. I'm going to put a remix that, me and Mr. Davis worked on like 2 years ago up on Broke Man Studio. So, last night I opened up YT Jail. YT Jail. YouTube Jail. I know it sounds fucked up when I say YT Jail. So it's all capital letters, YT Jail. YouTube Jail is open. I'm gonna find the boss, Francis Cooper. I'm gonna see if I can make him the first warden of the YouTube jail. You know, we call it YouTube prison, but please, you know, we're calling me niggers and, you know, he's saying fucked up shit. But if you get sent to YouTube jail, YT jail, you will be tubed. YouTube jail is a place for everybody to see your bitch ass and know who the fuck you are. So, thank you, have a nice day, and then you'll be blessed by somebody.